Hello for Tuesday, November 29th. The markets gave us a rally with the Dow closing up 291 points. Not bad volume either. Look at this. The volume's a little bit. I'm just a hair over the 60-day average of volume, more than it was during a couple of trading days the previous week. Of course, the last here is the Thursday or Friday, and that was half a day. So, of course, that's slow. And then we have Wednesday and Tuesday. Wasn't quite as high as the Monday sell-off, but it's pretty good for a Monday. Quite often, as you can look over here in the past, quite often on Mondays it's quite weak. So the bounce is pretty good, and it's also was at some areas. The Dow wasn't perfectly at the 61.8, but close to it right here. It had gotten down to that area, and so the move up is pretty normal. Now, of course, it faces the resistance here at 11,640. That is the 50-day, which should be touching from the underneath side if it does move up there, which, hey, there's no reason why it shouldn't, right? Well, we'll look at that in a minute. Actually, let's look at the we'll look at one of the Dow futures charts here. This one just shows, this was in the newsletter, I guess. So this is from the November or October, low, and then we went up to the high, and this is coming back down. We've got double sets of, on several of these charts, we've got double sets of fibs. So we'll point them out to you. I think if you've seen these enough, you've figured out, but this 50% is 50% of this total move up here. So it dropped below 50%, but the Dow futures did not get to the 61.8. Anyway, that's where we bounced, and moving back up, this other set of fibs is from the this particular last leg, because that's the one you're interested in seeing. First off, what can it do to move back up towards there? And it ran into the 38%. That's the second 38% line. And that's where it ended. And that's exactly what we thought. And we, in fact, we posted a chart on that, which is, in fact, titled it 38. So we posted this at 9:30. It probably must have been 10:30 Central Eastern time. Anyway, we just said that you can look in the stream, but we said, look, the Dow, and if we look up here, if we pull it up, which I think we can do, the Dow and the S&P 500 futures, it had actually run just a little bit above it, but it dropped a little bit below when we posted it. We said they both run to the 38% resistance or retracement line, so that's probably the high of the day. And sure enough, that was indeed the high of the day. And what I would tell you, when you're already up to almost S3, oh, you don't see it any longer on the charts. Here's resistance to our R3. I'm not showing R3, but when you run up that much, especially on a Monday, who wants to trust that? But they closed pretty well. So anyway, that was perfect as far as calling the high of the day. But just before the close, this, now we're back to a 60-minute chart. You can see in the last hour, it sold off pretty good here, down to 429. But before the close, people wanted to get in for the next day, evidently, because it ran back up to 495 area. So a big move, very quickly. It moved down, sat there a while, and it moved up. So if it pulls back further, we got the 38%, 11,381. That'd be the area to watch coming down on the downside. And I think we might have this also on the S&P 500. This one also moved up, and this shows you that it was indeed the high of the day. So it's nice when it works out that way. But so if this pulls on 1177, a possible support if it pulls down there. Okay, now we'll go on to the SPX, and we've got a couple to show. First off, this is just a weekly, but showing how quickly we made up a lot of that whole, a good share of that drop from the week before. We're not showing the monthly chart, but we said there's a chance in the next couple days we can make those candles look a lot better. Because at the moment, if they close that way with inside weeks, or I guess that was a monthly, it wouldn't look very good. But this bounce is doing good. So hopefully it can continue, and we do have, a different view of that, just showing. We'd posted this in the newsletter as well, showing that this is why we liked the S&P and why we thought we'd get a rally. There was one reason why against it, but the reasons for it were we dropped down to the 61.8. We also had RSI, which was just under 30 here, so move above 30 and 61.8. I mean, it's pretty logical. And we're down like, 6 or 7 days. So, I mean, your risk-reward ratio was fantastic for being long on Friday. although with all the news coming out, it could have been down big time as well. But the point is that technically it was set up real nicely. The thing that wasn't set up so nicely about it, as we mentioned also in the newsletter, was that the number of stocks under, when you're looking at pullbacks, you'd like to have as many indicators that have happened before happen again. One of those, as we showed, is the number of stocks trading over their 50-day moving average. If it gets down to about, sometimes it even gets as low as 10%, but if it can get under 20%, maybe 15%, 17%, that gives you more confidence. It was above that line that we used. It was like 22%. It's just one little loose end you'd wish it was straightened out. But here's a 60-minute chart, and this is the one we posted on Friday and put in the newsletter because, you know, we use Apexes a lot, and they don't always work. But when you have multiple things, and we had four good things here. We had the apex of the triangle for Monday. We had close on Friday at the 61.8% retracement. We had RSI under 30 and looked like it had already gone over 30 and back under again. A lot of times the second mouse gets the cheese. And then we also had Williams had been under the negative 80 line for a long time, so a move over there. So when you had one, two, three, four different things lining up, and as we said, with the apexes, we expected a big move, but you don't ever know for sure the direction. It could have gone down because a break under 61 could have happened that way too, but these other indicators suggested up, and that's indeed what it was, running up 2.92%. So that's the way it worked out. Anyway, this chart we should save these because put them in a book sometime just to show how often these kinds of setups you can trade them, and they don't always work out, I say, but when they do, they can work out very well. And if they don't work out, you know right away. They go below these areas and you go, that's, they're heading in the wrong direction, we don't want to trade it. Okay, on the Russell you can see the daily, the big spike up, and this was the thing we talked about last week. This one was really under completely its Bollinger Band, and this is not so often that you see that happen. It did over here, and it had a bounce, and it did over here, and it had a bounce, and so it's just a repeat deal. The thing is that this wasn't oversold, and so far as this time, the RSI hadn't gone lower, but it did that. Now, we can look at the bounce of that as well. The same deal with the S&P, the Russell had, where was it? At the 61.8% retracement. Where did it run due to the day? 38% retracement of this latest leg here. So it ran up to there, and that's where it pulled back. And so we'll see if it, we didn't put a reverse, in other words, from this little run for the day up, but you can see if it pulls back even to this first area where the 50% is, that's a possibility, an area to watch as well. And we'll just show a couple other of the futures charts, mainly here's one for gold, for instance, to show you it was a good move up for the day, but basically it's gotten right back up to this basic trend line, but this time testing it a little bit from above. So just see if it can, maybe it can just ride that trend line right back up there. And I think we have one more chart that's probably just showing the dollar, because that the dollar was down, of course, it was helped, that helped the market when the dollar, which had gone above its 78.6, was heading towards a possible 100% retracement of that last move, and it dropped, and of course the market went up. So then it started going back up again, and the market didn't care too much until that 1 hour. So, it's not that far off from its highs, and the market's up. So maybe for a while they can correlate and move together than just be correlate the, as far as the opposites go. So those are, that's what's happening there. As far as the GDX goes, we do have one green bar. We're not above over here, so that is a possibility. And we mentioned, you've got some good profits, so you do want to protect those. And I don't have the 60-minute chart up on GDX, but you can take a look at that one. And SLV remains unchanged like that as it is. Okay, so remember, some people think that, well, this is going to be over. Let me just go back to the Dow only because that one you can kind of see. Everyone I noticed, like on CNBC, the people are all saying, okay, fine, now this is not going to, if the S&P can get up even to 1220, that's a better short, but you could probably short it anywhere in here. There's a fool's rally and all that. But look what they said when we had the low in October. Everyone was there, was willing to sell their grant. Well, I don't know what you sell, but they thought the market's going to absolutely crash now. And of course, that's where the huge rally started. This time, they all assumed that, well, we've dropped down, now we're going to bounce up, which is normal, then we're going to really drop down again. Well, of course that could happen, but if you look at the times in the past that it's gone to these bottoms, that everyone was saying, oh, this is going to happen, we had good, decent rallies. So let's see what happens for a few days at least. Remember, we have possible window dressing, even so if it doesn't drop too much lower, that can kick in. The other thing is, some people like to say that all these, you know, it's all controlled by all the money managers and traders and so forth. Well, a lot of those people can earn huge bonuses, but to do that, they've got to get a little end of the year bounce. You don't want to end the year like this. So if they want to really push their efforts and get their clients into a lot of stocks and whatever they're going to do, they're going to have to cut out the work, and they may get their work going, and they may be able to do that as well. So we don't see evidence of it yet, but I'm just saying don't necessarily figure that this is an automatic short just because a bunch of people on TV are telling you so. Trade what's in front of you, not what you hear on TV. And the moment things are up, but you can see in a moment here that we'll show you what happened with some stocks, and then we'll get to additions to the watch list as well. First off, let's see if we can show you this. Just 1 second. I'll just briefly, quickly go through these because I don't know if I'll color them on the. I'm leaving town right after market, so on Tuesday. Hopefully I'll get a video up, but it might be a little later because I won't be in town, but I can do it out of town, I think. But of the ones with the gap ups, some things were tradable and some things were just gapped up, and nothing was hugely moving. You know, like we like to see things that really move up. We're talking 10-15%. We didn't get a lot of those movers. Some that moved up nicely, 6%, AREX, and you can see this one did come above this buy point, 11:30, and it moved up to closing there at 11:51. So that one's pretty decent. And this, of course, has a, you know, this one was a trade between this 11:30 and this 12:05. That was the idea of it. And the volume did increase on that one, so that one's still in play. Brocade. Gapped up, which made it tough, and the volume was lower. It was above average, but it was lower than that other move up, so this one was very not an attractive buy on that one. Just looking at it, not too good. And BYI, the same kind of thing. It was just the volume wasn't as great. It ended up okay, better than about average for the volume, but you know, with a lot of so many stocks going up, it kind of draws the power into a lot rather than the ones that are really moving, and that's always the problem. Now, CLNE did, this was a bounce play, and then did bounce, and if you caught it in here, you could make like 50 cents or so, and that moved up. But now it could be a play again over this 20 days. So any of these, pay attention to them because they could just continue. But if we have a little weakness and the market doesn't fall off more, then these might be candidates to buy right there. DNDN just had too small a volume. I mean, it had 4 million shares, but when we looked at it early, it did close over that 20-day. You know, we wanted 8.17. It's there, so it's, you know, it's fine, but it's just, you know, not much of a move on it. NLC, though, did pretty well, but it gapped up big, and that was a problem. I mean, big space, not percentage-wise, 2.66%. So this one also, if it continues, especially if it can fill this gap and play around here, maybe it could be a breakout, especially if the market moves up higher as well. MMM, you can see, gapped up as well. SPRD, I want to point out this one just because, look at this volume. Big volume increase, and it closed down. It gapped up, but it closed down. So this is a sign just to watch this one for still possible shorts, particularly, of course, if the market indeed does reverse in a day or so. So watch this one. And the last one, WCG, this one did move above the, we had a double lines here. One was a possible short or buy at the lower line, and did move above the upper line for the day. Okay, now we'll get to these additions to the watch list. And I don't think we have any exact prices on these. We'll see if we do when we post them. Anyway, they're ones that are interesting. And, I didn't realize this. I don't know why. I'm too blind. I thought this was still over a dollar. See, it's $1.03, and I was thinking this is $1.83. I don't know why. Anyway, well, we'll go with it. Here, it's here. So it's a dollar stock, all right? Usually we don't post them if they're under a dollar. It isn't. It's a dollar. But look at the volume. So you can read up on it. DEX One Corp, 5.6 million shares. Maybe a Momo play because it had big volume up, low volume coming down, going sideways. So if you like low priced ones, it can be a big percentage. If it moves up to 30, it's 30% move. It moves back up to this 130. So if you like to trade these, it's up 32% for the day. So you can see what it is. You don't want to hold it underneath these moving averages, probably. So if you don't like that kind of stock, we don't suggest it for you. Okay, ONXX. Pharmaceuticals, you know, we've had some pretty good moves with a lot of them lately. Now, this is the interesting one because it moved all the way up to 46. So it was a nice trade. 46.07 was the high, and it closed at 42.80, so $3.20 lower than what its high was. So this could be a continuation play. Look at that volume. Incredible. Now, the other thing to note, so you got that. So you got 42.75 up here. It closed at 42.80. Watch this one. If it pulls back a little bit, that might be good. If you like to trade it with something that's volatile in here, like Cena was during the day, a lot of people scalped a dollar or two or three from that one, or lost that much. But you watch this one on a short-term chart, and you'll see where it was in the past, and see if we can move back up there. One thing to note about this is just a single top breakout. It'd be a double because 45.90 was the previous one, and it went above that. You can see the 46.07. So just note that that is over there in the distance, and traders noticed that, and that's why it made it a little double top and it pulled back. But as far as trading goes, it's still. Looks like that's a pretty good one. Also, there's no good entry exactly on Bioscript, BIOS, but you can see increase in volume. It's come back up to this long red candle on the left. The one drawback of that, it hasn't been very long. It's only been a month, less than a month, a couple weeks. If this was back over here like 2 months, then we'd like that red candle better. Because a lot of times, shorts or people that got trapped will just sit on their hands and wait to try and get their money back. Here, they might want to sell, so some resistance. And we do have the moving averages just above. Anyway, it's a possibility here that good volume, this could break above here, and mainly that first candle blocks the other ones. So that's the one you have to deal with, in my opinion. VICL. You can see there over about 395, it got as high as 397, so we should say 397, but you can see the situation. They had increased volume. It's if people are more, if they want to buy this price stock, this particular stock, of course, it's going to move higher. You could also see we got moving averages shaping up, the 20 days above the 200 and the 50 day, and the 50 days just now, and that's probably why the move is breaking above that 200 days. So all of those are going to be in the proper order at that point. Got a couple more. AKRX is one, and that one, similar situation. You're in a little trading range here. It might just be for a scalp. It had increased volume on Monday. Did I call that Friday earlier? I don't know. Anyway, you can see not bad. It had a really nice little flag here that we didn't see last week on Friday. You can see how it closed. Nice big flagpole. Came down in a little pennant for 2 days, and then it shot back up again like that. Maybe it can sometimes go one additional day and then pull back yet again. AREX is a possibility right here. Now, this one really doesn't move that much. There's another one that we'll show you in a minute, the last one. But it had increased volume. It's around here. This 30.09 is a possibility. This is kind of a jumpy one. It isn't so great, but pay attention to them. Approach resources. EEP is the one we wanted to mention that can move quite slowly, and some people like them that move slowly rather than move fast. You can see the volume's been wimpy down in here for quite a while, all month long, kind of hanging around. But the nice thing is it moved up from October up to November, almost a month. So not big move, moved up 6 points, so that's decent. But the thing is that a good trend, and now it's going sideways. It could continue in another trend. But so watch that one, alert it in this area, and maybe you want to check the company out as well. And this might be a possibility over this 30.64. So that's what we have for this Tuesday. Hope you have a good day trading. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll be sending out tweets out, and I say we'll probably have it out, I think, tomorrow, but won't on for Thursday and Friday, doubtfully. So, but then we will, of course, have a weekend newsletter. Anyway, have yourself a good day trading and pay attention to the tweets. We hope there's some that we find that are helpful. So, thanks a lot. Bye-bye.